Good afternoon. Welcome to the session of this session, Fluid Mechanics. The subject fluid mechanics basically deals with the study of fluid and its properties and the behavior of fluid at various conditions. As we know that mechanics is a branch of science which deals with the study of forces. Fluid mechanics in this branch of science, which we will study the about fluid. The domain of this subject is not only restricted up to the basic fluid properties, but the behavior of fluid and the various forces acting on the fluid. In this subject, firstly we will study what is fluid and its properties. Fluid properties, as we know that everything in nature has its own characteristics. Like, for example, we are discussing about human. Human have its own features like hand, leg and others. In fluid itself has its own properties by which it can be differentiated or it can be explained. Fluid properties are density, specific weight, viscosity, and these are the various properties. After discussing fluid properties, we will study fluid statics. That means, again, that is the behavior of a fluid or study of fluid in static condition. That means fluid is at rest. At rest, what type of forces acting on the fluid and what is the behavior of this fluid under static condition will be studied in this domain. Third one, fluid dynamics. As we know that the dynamics means the study of thing in motion. That means in this fluid dynamics, the fluid is at moving condition. Again, it is fluid kinematics and kinetics. In fluid kinematics, we studied the motion of fluid without the force or without the cause of motion. That means in this fluid kinematics, we will study only velocity, acceleration, and we will not discuss any type of forces. While in kinetics, we will study the various forces that is acting on the fluid. In next, we will study dimensional homogeneity, that is Buckingham Pi theorem. Dimensional homogeneity theorem. In this topic, we will study it very beautifully to develop a expression between a dependent variable and independent variable without performing any experiment with the help of basic dimensional homogeneity. This concept is very beautiful and very useful to developing any relationship between variables. So in this fluid case, we will develop a relationship between a fluid properties which are further classified dependent or independent separately. We will further study boundary layer separation or formation. That means the formation of different boundary layers, that is different types of boundary layers and their separation, boundary line, this separation. After that, we will study flow through pipe, that is combination of pipe series and parallel. In this boundary layer, will be discuss laminar and turbulent. Okay, laminar and turbulent layers. And the flow through pipe, again in this topic we will study the various combinations of pipe series and parallel. For this course curriculum, the book R.K. Bansal, Fluid Mechanics by R.K. Bansal, you can prefer this book. Now, starting from introduction, fluid. Now, question arises in our mind when we discuss about fluid. What is fluid? Fluid include not only liquid but the gases as and liquid both are under the fluid. A fluid can be defined as a substance which can flow or which have the capability to flow under the action of shear force can we flow under the action of shear stress however the small may be. It doesn't matter how much shear stress we are applying or how much shear stress is acting on that fluid, but under the action of shear stress a fluid is flow. Suppose this is a stationary plate and that is moving plate, and a fluid is in between two plates. Suppose at time t equal to 0, these are the position of fluid particles. Next, t equal to 1 second, t equal to 2 second and t equal to 3 second, the fluid will deform the relative position of particles change. That means fluid under the deformation gone through deformation under the action of shear stress. That means that at t equal to 0 the position of fluid particles are these, but again at different time t equal to 1 second these are the different position and so on. That means if a fluid is at rest, agar fluid rest pe hai, is at rest, that means there is no shear stress. If fluid is at rest, that means it is clearly that the fluid is at rest. That means there is no shear stress at all. Now we are going to discuss some fluid properties. Fluid properties. Number one, density or mass density. It is denoted by a symbol rho. Density is what? It is defined as the ratio of mass to the volume. Mass of fluid to the volume of fluid. Rho equal to m upon v. The unit of density is mass kg per meter cube. What about the unit? M L minus 3. it is absolute quantity. The mass density or density is absolute quantity. That means it depends, it does not depend from the position. So what is absolute quantity and relative quantity, we will discuss after this. Effect of temperature. On density. Effect of pressure and volume. As we know that PV equal to MRT. As we know that pressure, volume, this is the ideal gas equation. Temperature increase करेंगे. If we increase the temperature, the volume will increase. That means density will decrease. Just write down this. Density equal to mass upon volume. Mass is constant, density depends on volume. And we know that PV equal to MRT. As we increase temperature, volume will increase, density will decrease. As we increase pressure, volume will decrease and density will increase. That means the effect of pressure and temperature on density. If we increase temperature, density decreases. If we increase pressure, density increases. Next property is what is the density of water? Density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. This is the standard gauge. The density of water is 1000, but in case of sea water, saline water and different sources of water, the densities are different and it will be given in question. Until unless nothing is given, we will assume the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Next is specific weight or weight density. It is denoted by omega. It is defined as the ratio of weight of fluid to the volume of fluid. What is the weight of fluid? Mg, mass into gravity. That means weight of the fluid and the volume of the fluid is V. Omega equal to mg over V. As we know that mass upon volume is density. That means specific weight equal to rho g. In case of water, the specific weight is (9.8 g). Rho is water, 1000. That means 981. The unit of this specific weight is Newton per meter cube. And what about the dimension? ML minus 2 T minus 2. Because weight ki weight hai ML T minus 2 upon L cube. That means ML 2 minus T minus 2. That is for water the specific weight is 981 Newton per meter cube. Now, as we can see that in case of specific weight, the term G comes in the picture. That means G. What is G? G is the acceleration due to gravity. For Earth, its value is 9.81 meter square second. While in case of moon, the g is g by 6 of Earth. That means the specific weight is not absolute quantity like density. It is a relative quantity. It is a relative quantity whose value will be changed, or it would be changed as per the location. That means specific weight of an object on this planet Earth and on the moon will be different. That's why we use a relative quantity. Or in density we have used absolute quantity. That means the value was unaltered, remains unchanged at any location. Now the specific weight or weight density depends on pressure, temperature as well as location. That is location. That's why this is a relative quantity. Next property is specific gravity. Specific gravity is the property of fluid is defined as the ratio of density of fluid to the density of standard fluid. standard fluid. Now, what is standard fluid? Standard fluid is nothing but it is just a reference fluid taken for the calculation of specific gravity. For example, in case of liquid, in case of liquid, standard fluid is water. If we are discussing or analyzing the properties of liquid, that in that case standard fluid would be water, while in case of gases, standard fluid is air or hydrogen, H2. Now, specific gravity of water is in the formula, it is given that it is the ratio of density of fluid to the density of standard fluid. While in this case, standard fluid itself